Are you still filling out hundreds of copies of the same PDF form by hand? Are you tired of solutions that require third-party plugins, macros, or coding knowledge? Don't worry, in this video, we will show you how you can automatically fill a PDF form with data from an Excel list with a tool, MailMergic. In under 2 minutes, you will have up to thousands of completed forms filled in with the data from your Excel list, whereas each row of the Excel list generates a new PDF document. In our example, we show how to mail merge a student application form with data from a fictitious list of applicants. Go to MailMergic.com and create a free account. After you've created your account, you will be redirected to the home screen. Your home screen probably looks a bit empty, so let's just create a new mail merge with a click on Create Mail Merge. In the first step, drag and drop or click the box to upload the PDF form you want to use as a template. It does not matter whether the PDF has interactive form elements or not. As soon as the PDF file has been uploaded, you will be navigated to the second step. Here, you can upload your Excel file. Make sure that the relevant data is on the first sheet of your Excel workbook and that each column has a column heading. After uploading the Excel file, the editor is loaded in the third step. Drag and drop the placeholders on the left side of the screen onto the PDF file. The placeholder names result from the column headings of your Excel file, which will later be replaced by the data from the corresponding Excel column. If no or incorrect placeholders are displayed, you can adjust them by clicking on this link. Here, you can see an excerpt from your Excel sheet. Select the row in which the column headings are actually located. With a click on Change Header Row, the placeholders are regenerated accordingly. Now you can drag the placeholders to the desired position and adjust the appearance, such as the font size or font family, using the toolbar. You can click through the pages of your PDF file at the bottom. With a click on Preview, you can see which data the placeholders will be replaced with later. Make sure everything is shown correctly before going to the next step. Once you've added all of the placeholders as desired, click Save and Next. In the fourth step, you can see how many credits will be used for the mail merge. Below, you can create further settings for the file names, such as the output options and the email template. Let's have a look at all the settings in detail. In the first section, you can specify a custom file name for the generated PDF files. You can also use variables to access data from your uploaded Excel file. You can define a variable by typing the character @ and selecting the corresponding column name from the drop-down menu. If your Excel file contains more column names than can be displayed in the drop-down menu, enter the column name after the @ sign to narrow the selection in the drop-down menu. To delete a placeholder variable, simply click on the X and it will be removed. In the next section, you can adjust the output options. Choose whether you want to download the output files as individual PDF files or as one large combined PDF file. You can also choose whether existing interactive form elements, such as text fields, radio buttons, and so on, should be removed from the PDF files, or if these should be kept. If you're not sure what to choose, we recommend that you keep the default settings. In the following section, you can enable the password protection option. This ensures that the final PDFs are secured and accessible only to those with the correct password. The first field lets us set a password required to open the PDF. We can enter a fixed password or use placeholders to personalize it for each recipient. For example, using last name, secure 1234, means each recipient's last name will be part of their unique password. The second field sets a password required for making changes to the PDF, such as editing or printing. This ensures that recipients can view the document but can't modify it without the correct password. For this demo, we won't actually set a password. So let's clear both fields before proceeding. A new PDF document is generated for each row in your Excel spreadsheet. Make sure you have enough credits available. The Always Free plan comes with free PDF files per month and can be easily upgraded if you require more PDF files. After selecting the Validate Excel Data checkbox and clicking Generate PDF Files, MailMergic's AI automatically scans your uploaded Excel file for inconsistencies, highlighting any potential issues. AI looks for typos in names and addresses, invalid email formats, incorrect zip codes, and other common data errors. Here, you can see that some email addresses are invalid and other fields contain errors as well. This helps you catch mistakes before they cause issues in your final documents. To fix these errors, simply correct them in your Excel file and re-upload it to MailMergic before generating the PDFs again. With AI data validation, you can ensure accurate professional documents without the hassle of manual checks. Wait a few seconds for the mail merge to complete. Click the button to download the completed PDF forms. The downloaded zip file contains all PDF forms as individual files. You can find the link to MailMergic in the description below. If you leave a like and comment on this video, we'll give you a free month on your subscription. Thanks for watching and see you soon!